Not too many people know that Jacques Cousteau's research vessel, the Calypso, was actually built right here in Ballard at what is now known as Pacific Fisherman Shipyard.
Calypso was built during the Second World War as a minesweeper for the British Navy at the Ballard Marine Railway Yard near Seattle. Launched on the 21st of March 1942, she was christened with the pennant letter J826 by a 12-year-old girl named Isobel Prentice. The 66-foot vessel was handed over to wartime Britain through the Lend and Lease program of President Roosevelt. After an eventful trip, she was stationed at Gibraltar for minesweeping duties in the Mediterranean and later took part in the landing on the beaches of Sicily in July 1943. After the war, she was returned to the US Navy and moved to Malta, an island south of Sicily. In 1949, she was decommissioned and sold to the Gazan Group in Malta to be used as a ferry between Malta and the tiny island of Gozo. Her new owner renamed her as the Calypso. Calypso, by the way, was the name of the nymph in Homer's Odyssey, who held the hero Ulysses captive as a prisoner of her charms on an island now known as Gozo. Commander Cousteau, who by now had begun to devote his life to underwater exploration, found in Malta his ideal ship, the Calypso. In 1950, this vessel was bought for him by Sir Thomas Lowell Guinness, a wealthy Englishman. Lowell Guinness remained the legal owner of the vessel. Commander Cousteau could use the ship as long as forever, but his conditions were: Calypso should be properly maintained by Cousteau, his name would never be mentioned, and Cousteau could never ask him for monetary help ever after. His youngest son began working closely with his father in 1965. He then made a documentary about Conchel Tree Expedition, their third underwater experiment in saturation diving. Six men, among whom the former astronaut Scott Carpenter, spent 3 weeks at the depth of 325 feet off the coast of southern France. This footage of Conchel Tree was broadcasted as a National Geographic television special, narrated by no one less than Orson Welles. During the night of January 8, 1996, she was inadvertently struck below the waterline in a barge maneuvering accident. With a gash in her side, Calypso was flooded and settled on her side in 16 feet of water, lying at an angle of 70 degrees. Was this the end of the Calypso after 46 years of faithful service?
Left to rust and rot, the Calypso is today but a skeleton of its former glory. Caught in a long-running legal battle, Jacques Cousteau's iconic ship is in decay. It's been sitting in this dry dock since 2007. The ship circled the world 15 times under Cousteau's command. Known as a floating laboratory, it helped the pioneer environmentalist explore the ocean and film the TV documentary series The Undersea World. The ship's demise came in 1996, when a barge accidentally rammed into her and sank her in the port of Singapore. The following year, its captain Jacques Cousteau died at the age of 87. The shipyard housing the Calypso is threatening to auction it off, following a legal dispute with its owner. Cousteau's widow has not met the deadline given by a court to remove the vessel and settle a €300,000 bill. But some, like workers at this ship renovation company in Brest, hope to restore her and make her float again.
For us, the goal would be to restore Calypso here in Brest and take back to sea all the memories and the legacy of Jacques Cousteau and his team's contribution to oceanography and environmental protection.
For now, the Calypso awaits what the future holds, a home where it could rest or a new life out at sea.
The 24th Avenue Northwest Street End, next to Pacific Fisherman Shipyard's Ballard Marine Railway, is currently being redeveloped as a stormwater retention facility by King County and the City of Seattle. Please support King County and the City of Seattle in erecting a 6-foot by 14-foot bas-relief bronze plaque honoring Jacques Cousteau and his research vessel Calypso, a tribute at her birthplace, at the foot of 24th Avenue Northwest in Ballard.